extraordinary events I'm about to relate happened many years ago. I was 25, happily unmarried. My father, Professor Pierre Aronnax at the Museum of Natural History in Paris, had left me in New York, cataloguing his specimens, while he went off gathering more in Nebraska. In that moment, the world, what little I knew of it then, seemed peaceful. Then, quite literally, out of the blue, a gigantic thing began appearing in the oceans of the world. Spindle-shaped, sometimes dark, sometimes glowing with an eerie light, far larger and faster than any fish ever seen. It excited curiosity, speculation, and fear. When on a summer's day, 100 miles off the coast of Ireland, it attacked the SS Scotia, a ship of the Cunard line, gouging a great gash in the vessel's iron hull. More attacks followed in the Atlantic and the world's other oceans, and so the fear grew.
Surely you're not admitting you were wrong, Father?
I did not say I was wrong.
You said it would be impossible for a sperm whale...
A cachalot, Connie. The proper name, please. The French name.
You said a cachalot could never penetrate the iron plates of a steamship.
My cachalot theory was formulated on the basis of the available evidence. Now the known facts have changed. I have adapted my theory. I now know the creature to be a narwhale.
A narwhale?
Monodon monoceros, the unicorn of the seas.
I know what a narwhale is.
The trilobites go on the arthropod shelf. Pay attention, Connie, please.
According to reports, whatever's attacking shipping is at least 10 times the size of the largest narwhale.
Ichthyology has a myriad unsolved mysteries still. The sunless depths of our oceans are as little known to us as the dark side of the moon. We have no idea what fantastical creatures may dwell in those unfathomable depths.
Papa. Kindly do not address me as if I were a lecture hall full of your students.
Oh,
I believe it's a boat.
A what?
Some sort of underwater boat. A submarine vessel.
Have you been reading novels again? You are utterly mistaken, Connie, about it being a so-called submarine. I shall prove you are mistaken.
Shall you, Papa? How?
I received this letter yesterday from the Secretary of the Navy, requesting my presence. Here, you had better read it yourself.
Shall you go?
I most certainly shall. It is an honor to be asked.
But why you?
I beg your pardon?
No, Papa. I meant, aren't there any American marine biologists who can hunt this creature?
My treatise, Mysteries of the Great Ocean Depths, has lately been published here. To considerable acclaim.
Of course. I know that.
Pack my trunks, Connie, for a long voyage. Perhaps as long as half a year.
Take me with you.
Don't be absurd. You're a girl.
A woman.
Precisely.
Take her up to half speed when we make the East River. Let's give those crowds something to cheer.
Captain Father Good.
Monsieur Aronnax.
And Professor Aronnax.
Welcome aboard the USS Abraham Lincoln, Professor.
I'm happy to be here, Captain.
I saw you on the dock when we were casting off. I wasn't sure you'd make it.
I was waiting for my daughter to come and bid me goodbye. She had something more important to do. Fine ship, Captain.
The Abe Lincoln is the fastest frigate in the Union Navy. Top speed, 18 knots.
We'll need it if we are to catch this giant cetacean.
Oh, we'll catch it. No ship's better equipped for the task. We've got every whaling weapon known to man, from Congreve rockets to a deck-mounted harpoon gun. And the famous Canadian whaler, Ned Land, is on board. Like to meet him, Professor?
Very much. But first, I should like to go to my cabin and unpack. Where did that silly girl put my armagnac? What? What on earth? Connie!
What kept you so long? I was suffocating in there.
No, this cannot be. Connie, you will go back to New York immediately. I shall tell Captain Farragut to turn the ship around.
I fear that's impossible, Professor. We've already dropped the pilot. Miss Aronnax, I presume.
Call me Connie, please. Captain...
Farragut. In 20 years at the helm, you're my first stowaway.
Surely we can drop her somewhere, Captain. Put her off in a skiff.
We just passed the coast of Long Island, Professor. We're at full steam. Heading out into the Atlantic.
What can I tell you about Ned Land, the Prince of Harpooners? Physically, he was exactly as you'd expect. Tall, lithe, muscular, perhaps 40 years of age, which seemed ancient to me then. An uncomplicated fellow, or so I thought. A man's man, who didn't care to be challenged or mocked, which was a challenge in itself.
A woman?
The captain said you had remarkable eyesight.
What the hell's a woman doing on board?
If I'm honest, Ned Land frightened me then. I sensed his distrust. He distrusted all womankind. His tightly coiled violence. Of course, at that first encounter, I didn't see the darkness that lay beneath. So, not uncomplicated at all.
We shall patrol the sea lanes where it has previously appeared and hope it finds us.
Hope is not a very scientific quality.
You think the narwhal, Professor?
What other marine creature has an appendage that could penetrate the hull of a ship?
An iron ship. Plates as thick as my hand.
Your point, Mr. Land.
I've known a narwhal's tusk pierce a wooden hull. Plate iron? It wouldn't leave a dent.
Exactly. Therefore, I believe it's a vessel that can sail beneath...
Connie, please. Try not to look foolish. Very likely, this is a monster from the lower depths, where pressures reach 100 atmospheres or more. Therefore, the creature's very structure would have evolved to resist such immense pressures.
So we watched and talked, and in time Ned Land thawed a little. I found him less intimidating. And the Abraham Lincoln sailed on, patrolling the oceans of the world from the Arctic to the equator and beyond. We saw porpoises and razorbacks and cachalot and...
I see it! On the starboard bow!
That's a bullhead whale!
Balaena mysticetus. An inoffensive animal.
Keep looking!
Days turned to weeks. Weeks became months. Nothing. The crew became... mutinous is too strong a word. Surly. Careless. Finally, 200 miles off the coast of Japan...
A million stars out tonight.
Foreign stars. Quite different from the stars over France.
Sorry you came now, Connie.
Not sorry, Papa. Disappointed.
When we return to Paris, I shall be a laughingstock.
You must try not to mind.
Monster ahoy! There she is! Our creature! Off the starboard bow!
Where? There. See? Oh, it is even greater than I imagined.
Papa, it's glowing!
Phosphorescence?
Oh, no, too strong.
It's an electrical brightness.
Fast, too.
Full steam!
What are we looking at, Professor?
A giant narwhal.
Ned, can you kill it?
You bet.
Seaman! That's my harpoon! You there! Hold the forecastle gun!
Our quarry kept to starboard. A cable's...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.